Any problems coming in?
Nah.
Guess they know now we ain't in the city.
Who, Mr. Milton's friends?
Yeah, they've had patrols out ever since you boys disappeared. Well, at least you're alive.
For now, yeah.
What happened in,
Guama?
Yeah.
Nothing nice.
What happened to Dutch? Because he seems...
I don't know. Seems as... what began happening in Blackwater began happening years ago, maybe. Slow decline, I guess.
What do you mean?
I ain't quite sure. What happened here?
I started gathering people up as best I could after you boys left. And John, you know that part.
I do.
And Hosea?
So that too.
Well, we got Lenny's body out as well. Robbed the morgue and buried them together. Follow me.
So, what's your plan here?
Well, I figure before we do anything, we need to make sure John's even still at this prison.
And how do we do that?
We need to get up high enough to get a proper look at the place.
What? It's on an island, ain't it? Unless you're planning on learning how to fly.
That's exactly what we're gonna do. I found us a hot air balloon.
You ain't serious.
Now, the pilot, or whatever you call him, he thinks we're just in it for a lesson. Bit of a tour. He's quite the character. I think you'll like him.
You know, I'm impressed. You really stepped things up, ain't you?
Hey, we didn't know if you was even coming back. Whole thing hit folks real hard. You can see it. Heron's gone falling fully into the bottle. Strauss is a bag of nerves. Swanson's actually gone and cleaned up his act. So I guess it ain't all gone to shit. I'm just happy you boys were able to find us. Javier said he got the letter I left at the post office.
That was a good idea.
Until the Pinkertons showed up. Oh, by the way, I've been hunting O'Driscoll boys. Killed two of the sons of bitches at a campsite last week.
What?
Yeah, seems they've drifted down this way now.
You're a busy woman, Sadie Adler.
She a beauty, ain't she?
From here on the ground, yes.
Mr. Bullard? Mr. Bullard?
Ah, Mrs. Adler! It's good to see you. Good to see you.
This is my friend I told you about, Mr. Morgan.
Ah, yes, Arturo Bullard. At your service, sir. At your service.
Arthur Morgan.
Well, it's a nice, fresh day for flying, sir. A day like today, an Icarus would have made it across the sea. Have you ever flown before, sir?
No.
Oh, it's quite a thing. Quite a thing. Now, put these on and hop in.
Well, ain't she coming?
Well, women can't fly, sir. Are you insane?
They can't.
Oh, no, sir. It does terrible damage to them, to their vapors. I thought everyone knew about that. Why, a delicate flower like Mrs. Adler? Heavens above! Or below. Ah.
Where'd you find this guy?
I told you two would get on.
Are you sure about this?
Certain, sir. Quite certain. Mrs., let us away. Wish us luck. I've only crashed twice. Now, pull on that rope and hope for the best.
You boys have fun.
How did you get out of this?
Okay, here goes nothing. Right, time to catch a few vapors of our own. It's a little overcast, but I'm expecting some good wind once we're high enough. We should still have some decent views over the river. Now, one hates to be coarse, but on the subject of ablutions, liquids over the side, solids, do your utmost to levy the situation until we land.
Okay, Mr. Bullard.
I had a client once who fell foul to a rotten oyster on the ascent. And the decidedly harrowing experience for all involved. Keep going, sir! We need to get up above the clouds. It really is stunning up there. You'll have seen nothing like it. Heavenly indeed. Quite remarkable, isn't it? Feels like we have a nice westerly wind, so keep her around this height. This particular vessel is state of the art, sir. Imported from Europe. Won't find more than a couple of these on this side of the pond.
So long as it works.
Mrs. Adler told me you were very keen to learn the ropes. We have plenty of those.
She did, didn't she?
Arthur and Arturo. How perfect is this? My mother was a keen student of the Italianate. My brother's called Baldessario, so you could say I got off lightly.
Look, I'm trying to concentrate here.
Did you breakfast in the city this morning, Mr. Morgan?
Not exactly.
Egg in my pocket here that you're very welcome to.
I think I'm all right, thank you. Recalling the ablutions discussion.
Well, just say the word. Maybe ease off the throttle there, sir. So, if I may ask, what got you interested in the pursuit of aviation?
I didn't, exactly. Mrs. Adler thought she'd surprise me.
Ah, a very nice woman. And no shrinking violet.
Definitely not.
I prefer slightly more feminine attire on a lady, but variety is the very spice of life, as they say. Or is it, though? Did you know they locked up the man who wrote that in a mental asylum?
I did not, Mr. Pollard.
Whoa there, no need to go any higher. See that building up ahead on the island? That's the infamous Sisica Penitentiary. We shouldn't fly too near to it though, sir.
Sorry, we're going in for a closer look.
What do you mean? Mr. Morgan, please, this is most irregular.
Well, you want a happy customer, don't you?
Look, this isn't funny now. What on earth are you doing? The guards are bound to spot us.
Calm down. They won't care if we stay high enough. I'm just looking for a friend of mine.
A friend?
Poor bastard has a habit of being in the wrong place at the wrong time. I heard they got him working the fields in a chain gang.
Dear God. Wind. Well, this is most unusual.
Relax, Mr. Bullard. Here, take over. Keep us well away.
I'll do my best. This filly isn't the easiest to control, you know. This was not the tour I had in mind.
That's not him. That ain't John. That could be him. Yep, that's him. Mr. Bullard, get up.
Good Lord, my heart is pounding. I must say, the specifics of this job were not described to me at all sufficiently.
Well, it's done now.
There's Annisburg. Is that Mrs. Adler?
Where?
Being chased.
Yes. Try and get us near.
Will there be more trouble, sir?
I expect so.
I'm starting to rather enjoy this.
Yes, she does.
Wait till I tell Mama Sally about this!
them on the other side. They must have followed us. Get behind something. This ain't over yet. These goddamn old Driscoll.
Can't stay out of trouble for one goddamn hour. You got that poor bastard killed for his troubles. I kind of liked him.
They got Combe, the government. They got Combe O'Driscoll. They're gonna hang him in Saint Denis.
Hang him? Okay.
Mm-mm. He's already been tried twice for murder and found guilty.
Sure, no doubt he'll escape again.
No, he won't, because we're gonna make sure of it.
We have our own problems with the law, in case you ain't noticed.
Dutch will want to see him swing.
Sure, Dutch. He wouldn't even help us with Marston. And our situation is really messed up right now. You know how things is.
Bastard's gonna swing. I'm gonna make sure of it.
Closely followed by Marston!
You saw him?
Yes, in the fields.
Okay. Then we go rescue him.
From a state penitentiary?
No. But from the fields? Yes. That we can manage.
Well guarded.
Guarded, sure, but not behind bars.
No, it's not behind bars.
So, that's how we'll do it. Bust him from his work detail.
I guess.
It's best just the two of us go.
The two of us is all there is, anyhow.
Good, because two is all we'll need. I'll get us a boat, a little one, and we'll sneak in and get him out of there. Meet me at Copperhead Landing. Thank you, Arthur.
Whatever you say, boss.
I heard that.
insist.
Insist all you like. Ain't happening. Arthur Taylor.
Taylor what?
She ain't coming with us to collect her husband.
Abigail, you ain't coming. That's the end of the matter.
See, there you heard him. Now let's go.
But
nothing. It'll be quicker and easier with just the two of us. Plus, John will be calmer without worrying about you. Ain't complicated.
Well, I ain't the crying sort, but I'm real grateful.
Yeah, we know you are. We'll bring him back to you.
Thank you. Thank you both.
All right, here goes nothing. The place is surrounded by marshland. Should hopefully give us a bit of cover to move in close enough to find a spot and look for John. This time of day, prisoners will probably be working the fence.
Then all we gotta do is take out all the guards and row our way out of there. Seems simple enough.
How many times, Marston?
Okay, bring us over. We good? Let's head for that watchtower.
Okay.
Stay low. John.
Hey, I think I see him. There's a group in front of that barn just to our right.
Yeah. I see two guards. Okay. Take them out and let's go get our boy.
Okay. Let's go over there and see.
Okay, come on. I think one of those guards was still moving. Arthur, let's keep moving.
Where is he? You see him?
No. You, mister. You know John Marston?
He ain't working today. Put the gun down, lady.
No. You put the gun down. Now. Where's John Marston?
He ain't in the work detail today.
Okay, well, I guess we'll go and get him together. Try anything, I'll blow your damn head off. You clear on that?
Yes, very clear.
Oh, no, you don't.
Come on, partner. You apologize to the lady for pointing a gun at her.
Excuse me?
I said apologize.
I'm sorry, ma'am.
Ain't no harm done.
So, where do we go?
Towards the entrance, I guess.
And who's in charge of this fine establishment?
Jameson, sir.
Jameson who?
No, Mr. Jameson. Heston Jameson.
Is he a nice fella?
He's been quite an exacting boss at times.
I look forward to meeting him.
They're not gonna let you do this.
Well, that's gonna be up to you, my friend. So, you a popular employee, my friend?
Not especially.
Well, I guess we're about to find out.
Come on, marching straight up to the front desk.
You better hope someone in there actually gives a damn about this fool.
Guess we'll see. We're gonna have to shoot our way out of here regardless.
Hold your fire!
Stay down!
Okay, friend, be cool now. Just do as I say.
Drop the goddamn guns!
Jameson! Is Jameson in?
He's inside, Denise.
They got Milliken.
Got him and gonna kill him. Unless you bring me John Marston. Right now. You got 1 minute. I'm counting. One, two, three.
Milliken, is it?
Yes, sir.
Will you count for me? I got talking to do.
Yes, sir. Of course, sir. From one or four,
oh,
sir?
Very funny. No, we must be at 11 by now.
11, 12, 13,
faster.
14, 15, 16,
17. Now hurry up! 18, well, this poor fool's gonna get his brain shot out. And over what? For nothing.
Milliken, don't stop counting. I can't hear you.
Hurry up and bring that asshole out here, you bastards. Come on.
Don't cry, buddy.
I don't want to die.
Yeah, I know. I know. Hey. Hey. John.
Hello, you two.
Now, no funny business. Well, Mr. Milliken here will stop crying once and for all.
Okay. Today's your lucky day.
Let's go!
Okay, let's go!
fellas coming here don't look too friendly. We best get out of here.
Come on, boys, let's move. I'll row. You shoot.
Seriously?
Let me. You're a better shot.
All right, fine. You just relax and enjoy yourself, John. Leave the real work to them as can still handle it.
Thanks.
Keep them off us.
I think I liked you better when you was all trussed up like a prized chicken.
No doubt.
Well, hurry up. They're gonna be on our tail soon enough if you boys keep wasting time.
Oh, that's us told them.
Hey, Arthur. Thank you.
Don't mention it.
Let's go. We should get out of here quick before the law gets wind of this.
So what the hell happened in Saint Denis? Is Abigail all right?
She's fine. Jack is too. She managed to escape when they got Hosea.
Hosea? That still don't seem real somehow. All them years, Arthur, he was like family. What? How the hell did that happen?
We hit on a boat. It was the only way out of there. The boat went down in a storm, and we ended up stranded on an island somewhere near Cuba.
Cuba? Wait, you're gonna have to tell me all this again.
It's a long story, but things ain't been good, John.
You're telling me?
We're holed up now in the mountains to the north, near Roanoke Ridge, and some caves there. The Pinkertons caught up with us again, and we had to move.
Yeah, seems Molly ratted us out, the bitch. So she's dead too.
Jesus! Maybe you should have just left me to hang.
And, I should warn you, Dutch didn't want us breaking you out. Said it wasn't the right time. So, might not be the hero's welcome you're imagining.
So much for no man left behind. I can't stop thinking about this. In the bank, when they grabbed me, he saw it. Felt almost like he had a moment to do something and didn't.
Dutch ain't himself right now. Or maybe he just ain't who we thought he was.
Guess we don't need to worry about who's his favorite no more.
Yes, not.
We told you we would.
John! What are you doing here?
It's good to see you too, partner.
I meant I hadn't sent for you yet.
I went.
But I said that.
Yeah, I know what you said. I felt different.
Is that so?
Yes.
And when Spring and John brings the law down on all of us, what then, Arthur?
Well, I guess we'll have another fight on our hands.
Loyalty, Arthur, it ain't. I had a goddamn plan! John, are my brother. You are my son. I was coming for you.
They was talking of hanging me, Dutch.
They was talking. They was talking. And now they may come and hang us all.
Arthur!
Oh, sorry. I was miles away, thinking of, I don't know.
Dutch said to tell you he and Mike have gone to Annisburg. Something about Mr. Cornwall.
Cornwall. Okay. Thanks, Mary Beth.
Have lost his mind? And no.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.